The explosion happened just after 7 o'clock. It ripped through Newnham House in Manor Fields, trapping people living there under tons of rubble. Within minutes, fire and ambulance crews were desperately searching for survivors. Seven people, including a baby and a newspaper delivery boy, escaped with just minor injuries. But later, two bodies were pulled out of the rubble. A gas leak is thought to be the cause. Minutes before the blast, a leak was reported.
Well, at the moment of the explosion, my wife, myself and my daughter were all in the bedroom. We were knocked to the floor by the force of the explosive gases rather than any flying debris, and I think it's because of that that we weren't injured. We picked ourselves up, and because we had been warned of the smell of gas, we guessed what had happened.
Just suddenly there was glass showering all over the place, and we heard this enormous bang. The next minute there was dust coming in through all the windows, and there was glass all over the beds.
I gather there could be as many as 8 people who were actually in the bedrooms, which are the worst affected parts of the block, at the time. The emergency services are working tremendously hard and with great efficiency. At moments like this, one realizes just how good they are in very adverse conditions, because there is an overhang of the roof which is unsupported by any of the rest of the building, which could come down at any time, but they're battling on through that and doing a magnificent job.
We had a report of a gas escape this morning at about 7, and our crews were responding to that when the explosion occurred, something just before 8:30, I believe. At this stage, clearly the first thing to do is to, as the emergency services are, to get into the rubble and look after anybody who is hurt and injured. After that, we shall be obviously carrying out an investigation to see whether or what the real cause of the explosion was.
The emergency services are continuing to look for people trapped. It's thought there could be as many as 6 people still under the rubble.